8 people were confirmed dead and 20 others injured in a fatal road crash that occurred yesterday at around 3:30 a.m. on Kampala Masaka Road. The incident occurred at Kavale Bugonzi stretch after a passenger bus collided with a truck. It involved motor vehicles UBP 9640 Isuzu bus belonging to Jaguar and UAV 988N Isuzu Elfu.
Tuwede mbato kaka, tuwa genye kule chintu kwa chiku babu kufwe. Tuwa de wakati, mwena kwa nge mbato kaya kwa zechi. Hili wansi. Mwena kwa gamba fwe, awa kwa gano kato ndabe ya kwa zechi. Tuwanta niso kusanti, mwene ngeri jetu hii tamu naka mmadilisa nga tufuma wewe.
According to a police report, the driver of the Jaguar bus attempted to overtake an unidentified vehicle by drifting into the opposite lane, colliding with the oncoming Isuzu Elfu. Both vehicles have been towed to Lukaya police station for further investigations.
Abantu abawera ddala munaana be baluguzeemu obulamu be bafudde era nga abawerako ddala abaddisiddwa mu ddwaliro ekkulu e Masaka.
Michael Kananura, the spokesperson for traffic police, urged road users to exercise extreme caution and adhere to traffic regulations, especially when overtaking, to prevent such tragic incidents. Hundreds of Catholics were on Saturday converged at the Uganda Martyrs Catholic Shrine in Namugongo to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the Small Christian Communities. Small Christian Communities is an evangelistic model where a small number of families come together as a community of believers, pray together, attend to each other's needs, and support each other in their Christian life. Celebration started with a pontifical thanksgiving mass presided over by the chairperson of the Pastoral Commission of the Uganda Episcopal Conference, the Right Reverend Vincent Chirabo. He asked Catholics to renew their zeal, commitment, and participation in the activities of the small Christian communities to make the church vibrant.
That the people that come out and lead us will be well informed and motivated to carry on this wonderful project. Please let us make small Christian communities a priority.
Mass was co-celebrated by Archbishop of Gulu, Raphael Pamonywaoraj, the Bishop of Kotido, Dominic Eibu, the Secretary General of the Uganda Episcopal Conference, Monsignor John Baptist Kauta, and several other priests.
All Christian communities have patron saints, and the fact of having these patron saints is helping them to experience in a very concrete and close manner the presence of God in their midst.
Leaders of the Catholic laity from the various dioceses in Uganda, including the president of the National Association of the Catholic Laity, Javes Ndianabo, the head of the laity of Kampala Archdiocese, Emily Chito Mwaka, and her counterpart from Moroto, Charles Modo, also graced the function.
Let's first take at least 1 year and make serious efforts in strengthening small Christian communities. For the next 1 year, every report that you will make to the national discussions and meetings, you will be required to mention what you are doing and the results of what you have done and your plans for strengthening small Christian communities from the diocesan level up to the individual families.
The celebration ran under the theme Reflecting on 50 Years of Small Christian Communities in Uganda. The UN Deputy Secretary General welcomed food aid reaching Sudan but said it was insufficient as she visited a border post in Chad to witness the passage of a humanitarian convoy. Amina Mohamed, during her visit to the Adrei border crossing, also called for a resolution to the fighting in Sudan.
Well, the people inside Sudan have suffered for a long time. There are many crises in the world, and we hear about the atrocities, we hear about the hunger. And today an additional border, an important border, has been opened in the last week. and we are seeing aid going through to try to reach those people.
During recent negotiations in Geneva, the warring parties made little progress to end the fighting, but did pledge to allow humanitarian aid to pass through two key border points. Mohamed said that this was only a small amount of what was needed to fend off the suffering in Sudan. She added that the UN was able to finance about 25 to 30% of the needs.
We did not succeed in Sudan yet. This is a small amount. We did not succeed in Chad. It's a small amount. So the crises in the world are many, and what we need for the international community to do is to bring more resources.
Fighting erupted in Sudan in April 2023, pitting the National Army led by General Abdel Fattah al-Burhan against the paramilitary rapid support forces from his deputy, Mohamed Hamdan Dagalo.